bus driver Daryl. Hi, kids. I'm Conductor Cam.
And I am Mrs. C.
Welcome to the Crossroads. We are going on an adventure as we read the Bible and take a journey with Jesus. What path are you on? Do you choose to travel with Jesus? The Bible tells us that Jesus is the way. Stay on the trail, for God's word is the truth. Let's invite others to go with us too, for God gives us life.
In Philippians 4:19, it says, "And my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus." Our next journey leads us to the desert, where we think about God meeting all of our needs in a dry and weary land. We just need to have the faith to trust him to provide. Check out our new Crossroads sign. Our choice is content or covet. Content means that you're satisfied and you are happy and joyful no matter what you're facing. But covet means you always want something that isn't yours. You always want what you don't have. If we are standing on the rock of God and we know that God as our rock is self-sufficient, well, then we can know that God will provide. God does not need anything from anyone. God has everything at his fingertips. We just need to trust that he will care for us. Knowing that God is self-sufficient, knowing that God will provide, will help us to be content in everything we face, content in every situation we have, and help us to not want what other people have, because we know that God will provide for all of our needs. He is our provider.
And we want to share that with others. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So let's stand at the crossroads and look. We're going to ask for the ancient past, the ways from long ago that God taught us in his words. We are going to ask where the good way is, and we will walk in it, and then we will find rest for our souls.
Let's check out our theme verse and think about how we can stand, look, ask, walk, and rest in the Lord.
Stand at the crossroads and look. Stand at the crossroads and look. Ask for the ancient path, ask where the good way is, and walk in it, and you will find rest for your soul. And you will find rest for your soul. Stand at the crossroads and look. Stand at the crossroads and look. Ask for the ancient path, ask where the good way is, and walk in it, and you will find rest for your soul. And you will find rest for your soul.
We're going to think about another song and how when we trust in God as our provider, we can trade our sorrows for joy, we can trade our worry for trust, and we can trade our cranky wants for contentment. God will take care of all of our needs according to his riches. Grab your sandals and march it, dance it, walk it out.
I'm trading my
as kids and stand on God's word. What's more true, North? God's word is like a compass. It tells us the way to go.
Jacob had a big family, 12 sons in all. Joseph was the next to last son of the family, and his father loved him most. Jacob even gave his son Joseph a special colorful coat, showing that he was his favorite son. Of course, his brothers were jealous of him. Who wouldn't be? Joseph had some strange dreams. Once he dreamed that he was in the field with his brothers, binding up stacks of grain in the field. Everyone else's stack of grain bowed to his. Another time, he dreamed that the sun, moon, and 11 stars were all bowing down to him. When he told his brothers and father these dreams, they weren't too happy. His father rebuked him, and his brothers just got angrier. But his father kept the dreams in mind. One day, Jacob sent his son Joseph to go find the brothers who were taking care of the flocks. He wanted to hear how his sons and flocks were doing. Joseph's brothers saw him from a long way off. "Here comes the dreamer," they said to each other. "Now is our chance to finish him off. Let's kill him." The oldest brother, Reuben, did not want to kill Joseph, so he suggested they throw him in a dry well and leave him there. Reuben had planned to later come and rescue Joseph. Before he could do that, some traders on their way to Egypt passed by, and his brothers decided to sell Joseph to them. And so Joseph was tied up behind a camel and forced to march all the way to hot, dry, dusty Egypt. Egypt was hundreds of miles away. They spoke a different language. They served strange idols. It was a strange new land, and Joseph would be separated from his family. Joseph was sold as a slave to a man named Potiphar. Potiphar's wife was determined to get her way, and one day she grabbed Joseph and tried to force him to sin. Still, Joseph resisted. He ran away from the scene, but Potiphar's wife had grabbed his coat. She was so angry that she lied about him to Potiphar. The accusation landed Joseph in jail. Not only had he been traded as a slave to Egypt, but now he had been thrown in jail for something he didn't even do. Even while he was in jail, Joseph stayed true to God. God had big plans for him. While he was in that Egyptian jail, he had a reputation for being wise and for telling the meaning of people's dreams. One day, Pharaoh, the ruler of Egypt, had bad dreams that perplexed him. He could not understand what they meant, and was dead set on trying to figure it out. He asked his advisors, but they could not help. He asked his magicians, but even they could not explain the dreams. Then one of Pharaoh's servants remembered that Joseph was known for interpreting dreams. Joseph was brought from prison and taken to Pharaoh. Pharaoh told Joseph everything that happened in his strange and scary dream. Joseph knew exactly what the dream meant, and he carefully explained the meaning to Pharaoh. Not only did Joseph tell Pharaoh what the dream meant, but he also told him what to do about it. The land would experience famine in 7 years, and they needed to store up food to prepare. Pharaoh was impressed, and he honored Joseph. In fact, he made Joseph the second-in-command ruler over all of Egypt. Although he had been rejected by his family and left for dead, he had risen to power and greatness because God was with him. Later on, when Joseph was giving food to the people, his own brothers came to him for help. You can imagine how surprised they were to see their own little brother whom they had left for dead. He was now ruling one of the greatest countries in the world. Joseph brought his whole family to live in Egypt. Even though things looked bad for Joseph, God turned it into good.
God is a mighty Savior. He is our provider, so we can be content versus coveting. We don't have to want what we don't have. We can choose to be content and joyful with everything we face and with whatever we have.
Hey, check out this song, and as we do it, join me and do the motions. And remember that God is holding on to us just like he was holding on to Joseph, no matter what we go through, good times or hard times. God works it all out for our good.
There's no space that his love can't reach. There's no place where we can't find peace. There's no end to amazing grace. Take me in with your arms spread wide. Take me in like an orphan child. Never let go, never leave my side.
This week, our big idea says that when we trust in God to provide, we will experience blessings and peace in surprising ways. God will help us get through hard times in life and will make them work to our good. God is self-sufficient. He is our provider. God is so awesome. When Joseph was going through hard times, he had to trust that God was still with him. But when he saw his family, he knew God's plans were for the saving of many lives, and his troubles had a purpose.
Now, God is self-sufficient. He doesn't need us. But the cool thing is, we need him, and God has promised to be our provider. Will we trust him to do what he says he will do? That's our daily choice. We get to choose if we're going to trust and be content or covet and not trust that he will provide.
Hey, check out this verse of the week. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose. Romans 8, verse 28. Remember, we trust God because he has a purpose to bless us, even through the hard things and the desert times of life that we go through, just like Joseph. Let's pray together, you guys. Dear God, we know that you work things out for good to those who love you and who are called by you. Help us to trust you, to follow you, and to love you. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Have a great week, everyone, and remember that God is your provider. He will provide for everything you need. You just need to trust in him. Take care. Bye.
Which way are you going to go? Boldness or fear? God is my rock. God never changes. Which way are you going to go? Content or covet? God is my rock, and God is self-sufficient. Which way are you going to go? Love or selfish? God is my rock. And God is loving. Which way are you gonna go? Hospitality and compassion versus lonely and indifferent. God is my rock. God is gracious and good. Which way are you gonna go? Just or fair? God is my rock and God is just. Which way are you going to go? Reverence or disrespect? God is my rock. God is all powerful, holy, and glorious. Which way are you going to go? Truth or lies? God is my rock. God is faithful. Which way are you going to go? Wisdom or impulse? God is my rock. God is wise. Which way are you going to go? Patience or restless? God is my rock. God is all-knowing.